got company. Well, I hope everybody enjoyed those drive-by shots that I did. Let's talk about the scooter motor. The one thing you should be aware of is that it is a brush motor. It's not a brushless motor. And this thing will get fairly hot if you keep it like wide open for a long distance. This thing will get so hot you can hardly keep your hand on it. So word of advice, even though this bike is capable of doing 26 miles an hour, you probably want to keep it around, if you want to do street speed, I'd say keep it around 19 to 22. It seems to buzz along fairly well on that and not get too hot to the touch. It will get hot, but it won't get excessively hot. And that's the thing you want to avoid, is getting this thing excessively hot. Now, if you do get excessively hot, the nice thing about it is you can stop using the throttle so much and just pedal the bike, because you can pedal this without any real problems. I pedaled it up and down the street a few times, and you know, with the low gearing that this bike has, it's not a problem. Another thing I want to discuss is I put a pirate flag on my bike. I used to have an American flag on it. I'm afraid to put an American flag on my bike. I'm afraid I might have some kind of confrontation or someone will try to beat me up. You know, I'm a small guy. I don't know much about self-defense. You know, I never fought that much when I was a kid, and I still don't believe in fighting. And I'm afraid to show my colors, you know? It's sad. Anyway, I just wanted to point that out. I'm 67 years old and I never seen this country so divided. It's sad. Anyway, back to this motor. So you wanna try not to overheat this motor. Not to say that you can't open it up. You can open it up, but you know, don't go for like miles at a time, you know, like do a quarter mile, half mile, then slow it down a little bit, you know, go down like 12, 13 miles an hour. This thing loves to cruise at 13, 15 miles an hour. It just zings. What I'm trying to say is you can hardly feel any resistance of the bike, you know, as it's rolling. It rolls real nice. So I would think you probably get a little bit better distance. Now that's the next thing, distance. I've been riding this thing street and sidewalk mode, both modes. You know, the sidewalk mode's much slower. You know, you get yourself down to like 9-10 miles an hour in that area, or 9 to 12, depends on the sidewalk condition. So what I'm trying to say is the best that I could tell is I'm getting about 15 miles. And that's because I don't pedal that much in the street mode. I just nail it, kinda. I like going a little fast, but at least I know about what the motor can do and what you need to do to cool the motor down. Go into sidewalk mode or something like that and cool the motor down. The other thing is, because this motor is a brush motor and it has a lot of low-end torque, this whole frame right here, even when it's sitting in the air and there's no load on the tires, I hit that throttle, you know, if I just squeeze it real fast, this whole piece right here on the frame will flex down a quarter of an inch. This will go down a quarter of an inch. So you can imagine what that's doing to the chain. So the frame is flexing. So when you put the tires on the ground and actually put load on it, that flexing now goes almost a half inch if you flex it. So you want to keep away from the idea of pulling on a throttle from a dead stop. You want to pedal it to get it going and gradually bring in the throttle. That's the proper way to ride this for the moment until we can get this thing reinforced. But you can ride it this way. You just got to ride it in a respectful way so you don't flex the frame. Okay. I would suggest if you do this, if you take it to the second level, which I believe I'm going to probably be doing, you want to get this thing welded up so it doesn't flex. So I think that's about all I have right now. So the keyway problem has been resolved. Since we put on a separate keyway and we put the bushings and everything in there to hold it together, haven't had any problems. In fact, it seems like it freewheels better for some reason. So that's one thing about this bike that I always loved. I love the idea that this thing freewheels so well. It's the best freewheeling bike I ever owned. It has all seal bearings in it. That's one of the reasons, even in the cranks, have seal bearings. So it's all seal bearings completely through the bike. So it freewheels really well. If any of you that don't own a quadricycle and you're kind of interested in buying one, you can get in touch with Quadricycles. It's called LLCquadricycles.com. This particular one is the Quadra Sprint, the single seater. They also have a double seater, which I think is the Quadra Sport, if I'm right. I can't quite remember. Just keep in mind the double ones are wider, and most likely they won't fit on the sidewalk. The single seater will fit on a sidewalk, as you'll see in this music video I'm going to be doing, or some of my earlier videos I've done. So you can call them. You can probably have them put electric motor in it for you, but you're going to pay through the nose. Just want to let you know that. So, or you could buy it like this and then do your own conversion. You know, it depends on how mechanically inclined you are. Now, I found an axle that's exactly 18 inches long, slotted, 3/16 slot, 3/4 inch axle. I thought I was gonna need a 19 inch, and I cut this to 19 1/4, and there's a good inch or more left over. So that 18 inch that's offered on Amazon would work. So you wouldn't have to cut an axle. The only difficult thing about this whole build was drilling these holes in the driving hubs for the wheel hubs, and drilling the holes in the driving hub for the sprocket, and making up a spacer to go between this driving hub and the wheel hub so that the driving hub isn't resting on the spokes down in there. So those are probably the difficult, most difficult things to overcome. But once I overcome those, and of course the keyway problem, it's been very dependable. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put one driving axle kit together. I'm going to pre-drill the holes. I'm going to have everything ready for it, and I'll put it up for sale. So if there's anybody that's interested and buying this driving axle hub system, let me know in the comment section below. I'll get with you. I'll reply on the comment to let you know how much it'll cost, and you know. So basically, what you'll get on the driving axle kit, you'll get the axle, you'll get the driving hub, the bolts for the driving hub and the spacer. You'll get two new bushing spacers, the three-quarter inch bushing spacers. You're gonna get two new inner axle bearings. You're gonna get the driving hub with the sprocket already mounted on it, centered, ready to rock and roll. So basically when you get it, all you gotta do is tear your old one out, put the new one in. And if you need assistance in that, I can provide a video for you to show you how to do that. But you'll have to specify or let me know. Then that way, I can leave the rest up to you. You know, what motor you want to put in it, what kind of motor, that kind of thing. I would suggest you stay with the electric motors and don't even go down the gas motor road. Only because, unless you reinforce this frame before you put the motor in. But just remember, that's going to add a lot more weight to the back, and this thing's already light in the front. You'd be better off with an electric motor and putting a battery pack down here to keep more center of gravity. So I haven't had any problems with the front end being too light or anything right now. But I'm sure after I weld this up, actually, I want this thing to pull wheelies. If you wanted to pull a wheelie, you can actually pull a wheelie on it. That'd be kind of cool. But I doubt that will happen. Okay, so I did a little music video, and so I'm going to include this at the end of this video because I'm just so ecstatic that it's running so well, and I'm very pleased with it. I got 20 odd miles more to go to get my 100 miles, and then I can take it to the second level.
Bye.
hope all you enjoyed that little music video. Once in a while, I like to throw an oldie but goodie in there. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the quadricycle itself, some of the pros and cons about it. This is more directed to people who don't know much about these bikes, so I'm going to show you a little bit about it. Now, what makes this bike so unique about any other quadricycles offered out in the market is its wheelbase size, meaning most of them are only offered in 20 inch rims and tires. This is 24 inch. Also, it's all on sealed bearings. No bearings and braces to deal with, sealed bearings. The other thing that's unique about this bike, instead of having a stiff front end, because some of the other quadricycles that are made, if they hit like a little slope, it can tip over, where this has a rack and pinion steering in the front. So basically, I don't know if I can get this on camera or not, but basically this whole tire will go up about 5 inches before the back even tips. So what that means is that this whole front end travels, the back does not. But so when you go into a slope, it helps keep the bike. I mean, you'll still feel a little bit leaning, but you won't tip over unless it's super steep. So but like driveways, stuff like that, you don't have that feeling like you're gonna tip over. It does interfere a little bit with your high speeds because it wants to, you know, do this little bit of thing, but I think a steering damper can take care of that. The other thing about this bike is the brakes are pretty straightforward, even though they're on the back side of the drum. I'd rather have those brakes facing the other way. But that's the way it's designed. And also to let you know, the people who build these bikes, it's made in the United States in this little town in Illinois. I can't remember the name of the town right at the top of my head. But it's made by Amish people. It's an Amish bicycle shop. And this is their idea of a bicycle or quadricycle. And I think it's actually really cool. I like the way it sets. I like the way it looks. I like the idea of the 24 inch tires. And I really was impressed with the chamo gearing they put in this thing. It's so well geared that you can't even tell that you're pedaling 93 pounds, because that's how much the bike weighs when you get it stock. I added a lot of weight to it since then, but this is so that's the only brake system they offer, is these they're a little bit they get squeaky after a while. They're high maintenance, basically. You have to take them apart and take a little sandpaper and arch them a little bit, put them back together, then that'll take the squeaking away for, you know, couple hundred miles. So, or a couple hundred miles, you gotta fuss with the brakes a little bit. Okay, so the only problem with this particular design for the motor, and I'll be honest with you, is that if you need to remove your brake shoe, just the brake shoe, just for arching and, you know, maintenance of your brakes, you'll have to loosen the motor, drop the chain out, knock the driving hub off the keyway for the sprocket and push it all the way back so you can get that pin out for the brake shoe. That's the only drawback on this. But other than that, it works really, really good. In fact, somebody comment on my last video I did that they had a Quadra Sport, which is a two-seater, and they did the same exact thing that I'm doing. with the scooter motor, and the guy said it works great, except for on hills. Now I can imagine it would probably be really hard on hills because, first of all, if you got a bike that's twice as big and you got two people in it, you got one motor, is struggling, you know, it's a lot of weight. So let you know, it does work. Someone's done it also. Now, the cons are the cons about this bike. No suspension. This kind of acts like a little bit of a suspension, but not much. It still bounces around a lot. But like I said, our steering damper should take care of a lot of that. But no steering, no suspension in this bike. It rides hard. There's no doubt about it. The seat comes. You get an option on the seat. I recommend you get the recumbent seat rather than the marine seat. It's more comfortable. Takes up more room, but it's a hell of a lot more comfortable. The other cons about this bike was you cannot find a bicycle, off-the-shelf bicycle electric kit that will fit on this bike. You're not going to find a wheel hub that size with electric motor in it. You're not going to be able to put a mid-motor drive in this because that bottom bar, it needs to come up a little bit higher, it won't fit. Plus the fact that the barrel size is too big. So that's another con. So they don't make electric motors kits for this bike. You have to wing it, like I did. I winged it, but it works. And somebody else has done it too. So that's encouraging because that tells me I'm on the right road. Anyway, I'm not sorry I've done it. I'm hoping I can take it to level 2, which I think that's going to happen. I only got like 22 miles to go, maybe. So anyway, I'm going to end this video at this point in time. So I'll probably update again at the 100-mile mark. And at the 100-mile mark, I'll reveal all the level 2 stuff I'm going to be doing to this bike. And I think a lot of you are going to find it very interesting. Until then, I hope you all have a good day, evening, morning, whatever. And talk at you at the 100-mile mark.